Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Our Lady of Perpetual Help. It's very good to have you here with us. Our psalm today is taken from Psalm 147. It's Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. I'd like to go over that with you before we get started. Thank you so much.
Good afternoon, and welcome to Our Lady of Perpetual Help Catholic Church. Today, we celebrate the most holy body and blood of Christ. This weekend, we come together to receive the body and blood of Christ, conscious of the fact that Jesus gave us his body and blood to sustain us and nourish us as we continue to carry out his mission. He is the living bread come down from heaven, the bread that is the flesh he gave for the life of the world, the bread that leads us all to eternal life. Let us give thanks to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, for the unique and priceless gift of the Eucharist, to which we are invited every day. As a Eucharistic people, let us stand and greet one another as we begin our sacred Mass.
Say a special welcome to Ryan. Ryan is our seminarian for the summer. His job is to keep Father Greg in line. And good luck with that. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you. And as we gather, let us call to mind our sinfulness and asking God for his healing and for his forgiveness. I confess. Amen. To you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and my words, what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. I ask, Blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. And O God, who in this wonderful sacrament have left us a memorial of your passion, grant us, we pray, so to revere the sacred mysteries of your body and blood, that we may always experience in ourselves the fruits of your redemption, who live and reign, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Deuteronomy. Moses said to the people, "Remember how for 40 years now the Lord your God has directed all your journeying in the desert, so as to test you by affliction and find out whether or not it was your intention to keep his commandments. He therefore let you be afflicted with hunger and then fed you with manna, a food unknown to you and your fathers, in order to show you that not by bread alone does one live, but by every word that comes forth from the mouth of the Lord. Do not forget the Lord your God, who brought you out of the land of Egypt, that place of slavery, who guided you through the vast and terrible desert with its seraph and serpents and scorpions, its parched and waterless ground, who brought forth water for you from the flinty rock and fed you in the desert with manna, a food unknown to your fathers. The word of the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, the cup of blessing that we bless, is it not participation in the blood of Christ? The bread that we break, is it not a participation in the body of Christ? Because the loaf of bread is one, we, though many, are one body, for we all partake of the one loaf. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord be with you. In the reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to the Jewish crowds, "I am the living bread that comes down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Jews quarreled among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Just as the living Father sent me, and I have life because of the Father, so also the one who feeds on me will have life because of me. This is the bread that came down from heaven, and unlike your ancestors who ate and still died, whoever eats this bread will live forever." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise.
We're told in another place in John's Gospel that after Christ had spoken these very powerful words that we hear today, that many people left him. They couldn't accept the reality of what he was talking about. And so they decided, you know, we don't believe that. Today, as we celebrate the feast of Corpus Christi, the body and blood of Christ, we're told that Eucharist is the source and the summit of our spiritual life. So everything we do in the life of the church, all the celebrations of the sacraments, all the social ministries that we're involved in of helping people, all flow back to what we do here on a regular basis each day when we celebrate Eucharist. When you come forward in a few moments to receive the body and blood of Christ, you say, "Amen, I believe." And if you are a Catholic, there's no option there. Either you believe in the real presence or you don't. And so one of the challenges for us is to try to figure out, if we read the gospel tonight and we hear Christ saying, "You're going to eat my flesh, my body, my blood," a lot of people who have a hard time with that in the regular secular world is going to say, "You know, that's like cannibalism. How can you believe in that?" But there's a dimension in the Eucharist that changes all of that, and that is the spirituality of Christ's presence in the life of the church. Christ tells us, "I will not abandon you, I will be with you always." And no more powerful image than celebrating Eucharist together. And so we gather in faith to come before the Lord. And we say, the body of Christ. In faith we say, "I believe." And one of the things that we might look at in the reality of our own growth in faith is that we're coming to believe that. Each time that we pray together, each time that we celebrate Eucharist together, we're coming to stand before the Lord and say, "Yes, Lord, I believe." And ultimately, we need to trust in what God says. And so we look at the words of Christ himself. "I am the living bread come down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world. And whoever eats my body and drinks my blood will have eternal life, and I will raise him up on the last day." Those few brief lines in tonight's gospel reminds us of what our life is about, of going to the Lord. And what a wonderful gift it is that each time that we pray together in Eucharist, we're able to come forward, stand in the presence of the Lord, and say, Amen. And ultimately, we are called to trust in the Word of God. And more powerful than that, than what we see in John's Gospel tonight. And again, he says very powerfully, this is the bread that came down from heaven. And unlike your ancestors in the desert who ate and died, whoever eats this bread will live forever. And part of that is tied to the mystery of God. And God for you and I is always going to be a mystery because he is God. The question is, do we have the strength and the faith to say, I believe? Let us profess our belief that Jesus Christ is Lord. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty. Consubstantial with the Father. You know, all things are made for us men for our salvation. He came down from heaven by the Holy Spirit, was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. Seated at the right hand of the Father, who will come again in glory to judge living and the dead. His kingdom will have my hand. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, who is in the Father and the Son, as of thou and the Son, adored and glory. I confess on baptism for the forgiveness of sin, and I look forward to the resurrection of the day and the life of the world. In longing for Christ in the Eucharist, we pray the Church and lift up our petitions to our Heavenly Father.
For the unity of all Christians, may we sit at a common table and work on a common mission to bring the love of Christ to all corners of the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those with civil authority, may they imitate Christ and give their lives so that all citizens in the world may live. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all priests, especially Father Gabriel Sabato and Father Miguel Solis, who are newly ordained this month, may the power of the Holy Eucharist inspire them to imitate Christ in their lives always. We pray to the Lord.
Hear our prayer.
For a stop to all racial and gender discrimination in the world, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who harvest, prepare, and cook meals for others in the world, may they receive inspiration and blessing in Christ, the bread of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the community of Our Lady Perpetual Help Church, may we, through receiving the Holy Eucharist, become beacons of light to our communities. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick today, especially Megan Pozovic, Matthew and Margot Indies, and Pope Francis, who is recovering from intestinal surgery, may our compassionate God embrace them with love and healing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Dee Dee Gilmore, sister of our pastor, Father Greg. May the angels lead them into the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The intention of this Mass is the repose of the soul of Gary Underhill. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we offer all these prayers through Our Lady of Perpetual Help. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God of love, you sent your Son to nourish your people. Receive our prayers that we too may work to feed others in the world. Sacrament and in service, we ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
I'd like to invite those with your offertory gifts at this time to come forward. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept your sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His holy name, for our good and good of all His holy church.
And grant your church, O Lord, we pray, the gifts of unity and peace, whose signs are we seen in this mystery, in the offerings we present here, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as a saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. And as we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones, dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
And therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks you have held each of us worthy to be in your presence and serve you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, that we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, John, our bishop, Eduardo, his auxiliary bishop, and with all bishops, priests, deacons, men and women religious, and all your faithful. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face, and have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God and Mother of the Church, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, that we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now, at the Savior's command, informed through divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation. And deliver us, Lord, we pray, from all evil. Graciously grant peace in our day, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. And Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles and to us, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer to each other a sign of that peace. Peace, God, and thank you, peace. Christ, peace be with you. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be
solace for the weary, bread from heaven. See.
And together, let us pray our missionary disciples' prayer. Eternal Father, we ask you through your beloved Son, the intercession of Our Lady of Guadalupe, pour forth and receive your heart, and your perpetual help. May the Holy Spirit renew and transform us into missionary disciples, so we may be bearing fruit for the kingdom of God. As we go forth, continue the work of Fray Marcos and Isa and Padre Esteve Aquino. Transfer us and make us your instruments of divine civilization, enthusiastic in our faith. May the light of Christ within each of us shine forth as a beacon of your own. Up to your church. Consecrate us in truth according to your will. Accomplish your plans into the radiant love and mercy, exemplified by the two saints who visited our diocese, Pope John Paul II and Mother Teresa of Calcutta. We ask this. And Fray Marcos de Niza, Padre Yosef Aquino, St. John Paul II, St. Teresa of Calcutta. And let us pray. And grant, O Lord, we pray that we may delight for all eternity in that share in your divine life, which is foreshadowed in the present age by our reception of your precious body and blood, who live and reign, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless us, the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go and announce the gospel of the Lord.
Speak to God.
Thank you.